to listen this orchestra playing in the beginning of the 20th century. Even we can listen Caruso singing. Even we can listen Mahler playing Mahler Fifth on the piano, or the last movement of the Fourth. We can even listen Brahms speaking, you know. And it's amazing the possibilities that we have. But the most important thing, I think, is the access. Not only to music, if not in general, to the possibility to be close to beauty. And what is amazing is that we recreate an art that is very subjective. The objective point is the sound. The objective point is that we have the music there, we have the score. The subjective thing is that you will feel different. Every one of you, you will feel different when you are listening a concert. And I love that. Because when you are sitting next to each other, or when I'm sitting there, you know, listening a concert, kind of music can be for me the most happy and hopeful music. And for the person next to me can be the most sad and the most depressing piece. And that is the power of music. And that is the thousand possibilities that music have. Especially when you are playing as a group, to try to create a speech, that is what we do, every rehearsal. And we speak to you with notes that Tchaikovsky, or Mahler, or Mozart, or Adams, or, I don't know, Beethoven create. But at the end, is this kind of mysterious point of the music. Many people ask me, what is a conductor doing there? You know, what is, you know, to move your hands in front, you mark the tempo, and sometimes you don't conduct, but you are so connected with the music, with the musicians that you have. The same happened from the musicians to the conductor. And you see, we have in our world, I don't know, many, many, many great conductors, middle generation, old generation, young generation. I'm so proud of that, to see so many young conductors now doing great careers and creating their own language. We are trying to create. I'm also a young conductor. Well, so. I'm already in the 30s. But it's the thing that you see, you know. You see a conductor standing, moving his hands, conducting, and speaking in a different way, with the same piece. And then is coming another conductor with exactly the same notes, with exactly the same musicians, and sounds completely different. What is that about? It's not about the conductor. When I see Discovery Dudamel, I don't like that. Because, well, why? It's, if I see in a good way, what that means is the future. Is what from where I'm coming, from Venezuela, from the sistema. I didn't create the sistema. I'm a pupil of the sistema. You know, it was Maestro Abreu that had this crazy dream to create this, and that works, and works really well. We can argue what is the future about classical music. What is the future about arts? But one thing is important, is that we need to give the access to everybody to enjoy this world. Because sometimes people say, well, but that is a boring music. That is the music for dead people. You know, that is music to sleep. That is my grandfather's music. You know, and it's because young people, they don't get the chance to listen. And it's only the chance. I don't expect in the world that everybody plays a violin or sing or do, but I think, honestly, I think a way to change the world, or the way, not changing, this is very utopic, don't think I'm crazy, yes, look to this guy, but I think in a way what an orchestra do, that is to speak together first, to create a version, recreate a version of a piece, and to give to you, and be sure of something. They are, each of them, they are completely different. they think completely different. But they create harmony, and they give the sound, and they give everything to you. And that is the best example for our world. You know, we have to start to, we have to be different, because if not, this will be very boring. But we have more to sing and to play together. And that is what that means. You know, it's not to play music, yes, it's access to beauty, it's magic, you know. Give me your instrument. No sound, no. No sound. No sound. You can have an instrument beautiful in your house there, you know, but it will be, you will not be a good player, no. You know, she has to play, you know, or he has to play, he has to play, they have to play, she has to play, they have to play, you know. And this is the thing, you know, sound. The sound is magic. We have a piece of art, but also, can you play a note? A note. Can you see the sound? We cannot see the sound. We can feel, and we can hear. And she can play without vibrato, with vibrato, marcato. All of that different, thousands of possibilities, the subjective point of all of this, no, you know, and everything is so different. So the power of the sound is the secret of the music, is what I think, you know, because we see orchestra playing and conductors like me moving the head, you know, wow, interesting, jumping, oh God, enjoy. But at the end, you close your eyes and you listen and you feel. So this is what it's about, all of this. And to give the possibilities to all of them, we have here children from, well, you are not so young. You were very young when I met you. No. My first concert in LA, they played at the Hollywood Bowl, and they were like this. Now they are. But it's great to see them, you know, enjoying being here, sharing, you know, with you, and you sharing with, you know, this kind of beautiful power. Beauty. That is why we will play this piece.